For those who are in Kenya, allow me to make a warning. Allow me to make a warning from the office God has given me. We cannot operate from a place of fear. We shall not operate from a place of fear. We are giving the battle and the opposition and the things of the devil a lot of concentration instead of concentrating on what God has said concerning Nation Kenya. Nation Kenya is in the hands of God, and God does not give an affliction a second time. Affliction of 2007 and what happened before other years, it will never happen again in Kenya. What God will do, and I have given him permission, is to clear everybody and anything that is standing on his purposes, on the way of his purposes in this nation. Kenya will not hurt Abe. We shall not praise Abe. We cannot hail Abe. We cannot. Kenya belongs to the God of all creation. Kenya belongs to God, and anything that is not God's agenda will not prevail in this nation. So I am asking the church, Kaidre, let our confession change. Let us decree the word of God. The Bible says we have been made priests and kings. So let us win the battle in a place of decreeing and declaring. This is no time to just lock ourselves in. You know, it is a moment, wherever God has placed you, keep declaring, keep decreeing the word. At the command of God, I held a 24-hour prayers last week, the command of God, and at midnight the Lord told me the assignment he gave me is to break the bad waters, because many intercessors and the church, we have been praying for the nation of Kenya, but we have not been breaking through, and that is already done. So it is already done. It's a new day for the nation of Kenya. We decree and declare the word of God. Hallelujah. Very soon I will tell you who our president. I'm not a politician, but I am in an office of a prophet in this nation by the grace of God. When God allows me, I will speak it out. I'll give direction. I have sat with some politicians. I have told them the truth. Those who have come to see me, I have told them the truth. We know who our next president is. We know who he is. Our next president will be a man like David, coming from the bush, coming from nowhere. Hallelujah. And it is a desire of God for our next president to have a the desire of God for us to have a woman deputy, because there is a fatherly grace that God has entrusted in the hands of women in the nation of Kenya right now. I say a fatherly grace that God has released upon women in the nation of Kenya right now. Kaide women, wherever you are, let us rise up. There's something I will not say here, but there's a special grace that God has released upon women in the nation of Kenya right now. Okay? So let us any hangovers, and let us know that it's a new day for the nation of Kenya. It's a new dawn. It's a new season. Even as we camp and pray, we are doing this from a place of understanding, and we know that God is together with us, and something new is happening in the nation of Kenya. Now, this spirit you are seeing, even our children burning schools and the strange fires in Gikomba and all those things, these are demonically instigated episodes, and it is a season the devil wants to divert the course of the church. We remain on very high alert. We are in charge. We have taken charge of this nation. We are in charge. Even from wherever I'm seated confidently, I can say we are in charge of the affairs of the nation of Kenya. Hallelujah. Every alliance that is a conspiracy of the enemy, God will turn it into foolishness. That is God for you, because his word is forever settled in heaven. All right? So I will talk about the next president very soon. God bless you. Thank you.